Stuart. I want you to tell me a little about what's going on today and what's going on this weekend.
Well, actually, right now, as you can see, we have a lot of vehicles rolling in tonight. We still have some. They're going to be coming in all night long. We don't lock the gates tonight. And we're registering people at the stage right now. I think so far we're probably in the 80s as far as numbers here. And then this weekend, it's on-site camping. It's free. And we're just going to have a good time, man. Tomorrow night, we got Get Lowe's down here, and we'll have a little after party, and then all the events during the day.
Tell me a little bit about the history of Last Resort, how it came to be, and what it is now.
Last Resort, actually, even though this is our fifth year anniversary, it started about 8 years ago. I did it at a local Downtown Alive, and 1 year they started road construction in my area, and we were able to move it to the park in 2008. And I asked them if we could camp here for the weekend, and they let it go, and then been here ever since.
So how has the show grown from, say, the first year to what it is today?
The first year that we moved it out here, we had 108 vehicles and two vendors. Now we're in the 250-plus vehicles, and this year's our largest year. We have 20 vendors.
What makes a show in Louisiana unique? I think there's a different culture here as opposed to shows in the South or in the West. Louisiana itself is really unique. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Absolutely, dude. I think it's the atmosphere. It's hometown. You know, everybody shows up. Hey, grab a plate of food. You know, grab a drink. It's very laid back. I like every car show that I go to, but it's not the busy parking lot shows where you feel like you have to do something the whole time. I mean, it's a lot of hanging back, just talking with friends and seeing good trucks.
The nerve of these niggas, they acting like they done already made it. Practice make perfect, so practice to be my mama's mating. These niggas lame and uneducated and constipated. When I relay it, every statement should be the defecation. My dinner made by respected Asians, I dress amazing. My shirt so crazy, I get away with some sketches shape up. Such a lie, for I couldn't get up out these nights. Number 5 Tokyos don't even know the price. Bitch, we ballin' like we ain't harvestin' for tomorrow. We ain't no gangsters, but we gon' mob up before we borrow. Gold bottles, flow gettin' me Asiago. We're braggadocio like Randy Macho Man or Jotaro. I'm a Slim Jim, is designated to your lady. Not a binge friend, I'm sliding in that new Mercedes. Or whatever her name is, she just like niggas famous. And I bet she see the light, no, that's Benjamin Franklin. You becoming is funny, privacy limited, though I'm living with comfort. How can you really do it? How can you really love it when women who never loved you is showing you so much of it? Real niggas respect me, I ain't switch up my image. Real women respect me, they can tell that I listen. And little niggas is mad that I'm winning and got opinions, but got no bitches, won't pop a pistol, pop up and mention. God bless him, a cigar filled with all my stressing. Don't own a mirror, but made a million simply reflecting. Till my respect is on Malcolm X, I apply the pressure. Lucaya closed from my line, I wrote no lying, go check it. And I do this for the culture, and I'm hoping I can motivate and do a big as Oprah. Word, real nigga shit, you might gon' need some help. Hit the scene, guillotine, niggas head of themselves. Route.
All right, well, we're here at day two of Last Resort 2012, a few moments away from the awards presentation, and we're here with Robert Hensley of Recognition Concepts, and he's going to go over a little bit about what went into the design of this award.
Well, we use the oil tower theme. So kind of basically, this is aluminum and it's laser etched. So when the laser actually hits the aluminum, it turns black. And then we did some bright color printing on some black acrylic and it turned out real good. All right, we're here at our final day at Last Resort 2012, and we're at the beautiful oil and gas park in Jennings, Louisiana, and I'm here with my good friend Stuart. Stuart, tell us a little bit about the preparation that goes into the show. I know that there's a big area to maintain here, and I was curious to know who's helped you put all this thing on.
Well, I'm very fortunate. For 5 years now, I have a good buddy of mine, Felix Hebert. He's become a right-hand man, my go-to person the weekend of. He pretty much runs the show for me so I can handle all my business. And my family, I have four sisters here that work for me the whole weekend. My wife, sticks by my side and hates me the whole weekend, so while we stress out together. And then we have a few other friends that have been here since day one that always help us out. We very much appreciate it.
Preparations for 2013, is already in the works?
Yeah, we're already in the works. Already have some corporate sponsors that have signed up a couple months back, and we'll be gearing back up. I know I'm going to take about a month off, and then we'll promote about 11 months out of the year.
And look at the same location?
Yes, definitely.
Name of the show, where'd that come from? Is that a big Papa Roach?
No, it's not, and it's funny. Gator Drag Brandon, I love this one. Yeah, this is the old location for Gator Drag. Everybody knows that, and then it's moved locations. And afterwards, the city was kind of, they weren't too keen on having another show here. And I've been around Jennings all my life, and they let me do it. And I think that's where the name came from. It was a last resort car show for Jennings. You know, if this car show could make it in Jennings, it'd be great. And then if not, hey, we at least tried.